Hello students, welcome to MJC Learning. For standard 12th subject information technology for commerce stream, we are learning the 10th part of computer accounting with GST chapter. Today in this session, we will see how to solve a problem of GST with SGST and CGST, state and central GST on the goods using Tally ERP 9 software. Okay, this is the first example I'm solving in this software, Tally 9 software. Let's read the problem first. With the help of any open source or free education version accounting software, create a company named Sri Ganesha Trading Company. So using Tally ERP 9 software, we will be using this company, creating the company Sri Ganesha Trading Company. Shahapuri Estate, Kolhapur, Maharashtra is the address with the pin code 416004 with GST number 27. This is the code for Maharashtra. ABCDE2345F. 1Z4. Enter the following transactions in appropriate vouchers by applying GST and prepare sales or sales tax invoice and GST reports. So this is the first transaction on 1st April 2019. So we have to create a file in the academic year 1920. Okay, for the financial year 1920. So on 1st April 2019, purchased 50 units CCTV at rupees 10,000 per unit. GST is 28% from Shiva Enterprises, Kolhapur, Maharashtra with pin code 416001. It's a purchase entry. We are purchasing 50 units of CCTV. Okay, so we will be using purchase voucher, but with the inventory part, it is not purchase debit to Shiva Enterprises. Here we have to pass the inventory transaction also. So you are purchasing 50 units of CCTV, so you will be creating CCTV as the inventory name, unit as the unit name, and 50 is the quantity and 10,000 is the value per unit. All these things you have to remember. Okay, with GST 28% from Shiva Enterprise, Kolhapur, Maharashtra. Okay, this is a district in Maharashtra, so within the state. Pin code 416001. And the second entry is dated 2nd April 2019. A sales entry, sold 30 units of CCTV at rupees 12,000 per unit. GST 28% to Angels Public School, Satara, Maharashtra. Pin code 415001. Okay, so this is the one whom we are purchasing from, and this is the debtor to whom we are selling. Okay, so this will be the sales entry, this will be the purchase entry. So purchase, Shiva Enterprises, sales, Angels Public School, and the GST, two ledgers. So total six ledgers we will have to create. Remember this. One stock item we have to create, CCTV. Okay, CCTV camera. One stock item is to be created. Fine. So this is the problem. Now see the solution. The above transactions clearly indicate that the purchase and sale both are within Maharashtra state. One is in Kolhapur, second is in Satara. Both are in Maharashtra state. Therefore, 28% GST is applicable as 14% SGST and 14% CGST, state and central. Okay, so here we are starting with the problem. Now last session I had shown you how to work with Tally 9 software. Okay, so that way we are starting with the creation of a company. So here you have to create a new company. This is the step one. Create a new company in the name of Sri Ganesha Trading Company with the given address and the PIN code. Here you have to refer to the question again. Financial year begins on 1st April 2019. Enable the GST features by selecting features, statutory and taxation. This feature you will get in the configuration details. You have to go for features and put this feature on. By default, it is off. So enable the goods and service tax GST option to yes. Set alter GST details also you have to set to yes. I'll show you the screen. Only remember the options. Statutory and taxation, enable goods and service tax has to be set to yes. And set alter GST details has to be set to yes. Okay. Type the state Maharashtra and this GST number for that. So first we are opening the Tally software. This is the gateway of Tally. Select this option, create company, or you can just press C. It's a shortcut key to execute this command. So create company, then it will come to this screen. In this screen, you have to company creation screen. You have to type the name of the company, Sri Ganesha Trading Company. The country, okay, address you have to input. I have not input the address. State will be Maharashtra. This you have to select. A drop down list will come here. From that, you have to select Maharashtra, put the PIN code, all the details. Okay, financial year beginning from 1st April 2019. Books also beginning from the same date. We have the first transaction on this date only. Books beginning from same date. And accept all these details. Save the file, which comes to the next screen. After the company is created, you have to put on the GST features. So press the F11 key. Here I have mentioned to put on the features. Okay, so enable the goods and services tax GST option to yes. Understood? Go to features by pressing F11 key. Under this option, statutory and taxation, you have to put these two features on. By default, they are no everywhere. You have to put this on and alter, set alter GST details to yes. The steps are explained in the previous slide. Have a reference to that. Okay, so after both these, then type the state to Maharashtra, put the other details and accept them, save them. Now come to the step two. Here you are creating the ledger accounts. I told you total six ledgers we have to create. Okay, from the gateway of Tally, first screen, choose the accounts info option. Then come to ledger, single and create. After following these steps, you will come to the ledger creation screen. In this ledger creation screen, the name of the company will be visible in the title bar. Type the name of the ledger as purchase account. Okay, this will be the purchase account. Classify it under the purchase accounts group. Remember, we had learned so many groups in Tally. So classify this under the proper group. Purchase is under purchase account. Then inventory values affected, yes, will be done already. Is GST applicable? Yes, applicable. Set alter GST details to yes here. Okay, this should be there. GST is applicable. Set alter GST details to yes. Now, from the configuration menu, here you will get a key panel aside. Configuration is written there. Okay, press the F12 key for configuration. In that configuration menu, you will have an option purchase taxable. see the screen. You will get the screen. Okay, classification. The nature of the transaction has to be set to purchase taxable. There will be again a menu. So you have to choose this option from here. Okay, purchase taxable should be set on. Fine. Taxability, again, taxable option will be there. Okay, and here you are showing the integrated tax as 28%. Only put this on, this automatically will be coming. Okay, integrated tax has to be put on to 28. Okay, because central tax is 14 and state tax is 14. So central tax and state tax will be automatically reflected as 14-14 respectively. Okay, after this screen, save this. Okay, then again you will come to the this option. So that screen which I showed you just now, that will be when you press enter here, set alter GST details set to yes, then this screen will come. And after this, when you save it, again it will come to this screen. Then here you have to choose type of supply goods. See the steps properly, what option I'm putting on. Type of supply should be goods. You are purchasing goods. Okay, with 28% GST. So wherever the options are to be put, put it properly. There are goods and services. Here we are applying GST on goods in this problem. So select the goods option from here. Okay, and then accept it. No amount and all is to be put here. Save the purchase ledger. Next, we are creating the sales ledger now. Same way, accounts info, ledger, single, create. The ledger creation screen will open. Again, put the sales account here, but classify it under sales account. See, these are the list of groups. From here, you will be choosing the sales account. For purchase, you will be choosing the purchase account. Okay, so classify the under section properly. Then inventory values affected, yes. We have to list inventory, so this option has to be set to yes. Then is GST applicable? Applicable. Set alter GST details? Yes. Okay, after this yes, you will come to the configuration menu again. Now the configuration menu, how I had shown, this type, this menu, but it will be sales account here. Okay, same way here you have to say it will be now sales taxable. And show GST. This will be sales taxable. Okay, show GST tax types. Again, you have to put integrated as 28. So CNS GST will be 14-14 automatically reflected. Okay, lastly, type the supply option as goods. Same way. Okay, only sales part is to be changed, rest all is same. And sales taxable instead of purchase taxable in the configuration menu, and then save the ledger. So two ledgers are created, purchase and sales. Third ledger to be created is SGST. Later on CGST also you have to create in the same manner. Okay, one I'll show you. Third ledger, type SGST here under duties and taxes. Okay, all these are taxes, so it has to be under the group duties and taxes. Type of duty or tax, you will be putting GST, and tax type will be state from this menu. Okay, this is the state tax, and accept it. Okay, that is to save. Nothing else is to be changed, that's all, only the three things, and then save it. So same steps you have to do when you are creating the CGST account ledger. Okay, but you have to create again two ledgers for the debtor and creditors. How to create for debtors and creditors, we have learned earlier when we were discussing vouchers. So here you will be putting Angel Public School and classifying it under sundry debtors. Okay, nothing all there, the tax options and all will not be visible. Okay, they are the people, parties. So Angel Public School will be under sundry debtors, and Shiva Enterprise account will be under sundry creditors. Okay, so these three ledgers you have to create. Fine. Only that when you are creating CGST ledger, this will be central tax. For SGST, it is state tax. For central CGST account, it will be central tax. Only that is the change. Fine. Then these two ledgers you have to create and save them. So that is the step two. Now next come to the inventory part. The step three, how to create the inventory and fill details in that. Here you have to make a note that GST rates applicable for each commodity are given at the time of creation of stock items. Okay, so when you are creating the stock items only, you have to put the slab of GST, whatever percentage is given. Later on, automatically it is calculated in the voucher. So when you are putting the stock item, you have to give the GST rate that time itself. Fine. Now here, how to create the unit of measure first? Because in the item, the unit is to be used. So first go to create units of measure. How you will go about? From the gateway, go from the inventory info. Select the unit of measure option. Type the unit name. Okay? As unit or numbers. CCTV camera, how you measure it as units or numbers. And save it. No other option is to be changed. Follow? Next, you have to create the stock item product as CCTV. So with the GST rate 28%. So how you will go about? From the inventory info, you have to select this option, stock items. See, when you are creating unit, you will be selecting unit of measure. When you are creating stock item, you will be selecting stock items option from this main menu, inventory info, stock items, then create. Then type the name of the item or the product as CCTV. Select the unit of measurement. We have already created the unit, so you will get a list. From that list, you have to select the unit. Okay, as unit or numbers, whatever you have given. Then you will get the option set alter GST details. I had shown you in the previous menu, remember? So here you have to set the alter GST details to yes. And then give all the GST details for that stock item like HSN, taxability, IGST percentage which is given, CGST percentage, SGST percentage, etc. Okay, this all has to be allocated. Type of supply should be goods. And then save that stock item. Fine. So these all things you have to remember and put it properly. Next is the step four. Create the purchase voucher. Okay, see, this is how your purchase voucher will look like. You have the purchase voucher number, okay, invoice number, the date here, then the party's account name. We were purchasing from Shiva Enterprise account. So when you create this ledger, it has to be only selected here. Purchase ledger we had created under purchase account. And these items we have to create. How to fill up all this is explained here. So from the gateway of Tally, you will be going to the option accounting vouchers. Then you will be selecting purchase voucher, F9 key. Type the voucher date as 1/4/2019. To put the date, which key we are using? F2. Type the supplier invoice number. How I have given here, any number you have to input. Then type the party's name as Shiva Enterprises. Okay, here you will be selecting it. purchase ledger field should be selected as purchase account. Then select name of the item. This is already created as CCTV. Enter the quantity as 50. Okay, this has to be typed. Remaining this has to be all selected. CCTV unit is all created. Enter the quantity as 50 and rate as 10,000. Then you have to select the SGST option. Okay, automatically the SGST will be calculated on your total. And then lastly, save it. Okay, so your purchase ledger or voucher looks like this. Same. Name of the party, the purchase account, the invoice number and the date here. Then under the name of item, you have to put all the inventory stock items which you have created. Here there will be only one now, CCTV. 50 units at 10,000 per unit. So this will be calculated automatically. Amount column is calculated automatically. Come out of the total. Then you will get a ledger screen. Select SGST first. This is given as 40%, remember? And this is given as, 14%. This is given as 14%. That makes it 28. So on this, it will be automatically calculated. 70 and 70 respectively. This will come automatically. Because inbuilt, when we are creating the ledger only, we have given the percentage as 14 there, okay, or 28, and it's come on its own, but it will be calculated automatically, and this will be having a grand total. This also will be calculated automatically. So this is the purchase voucher. Next part is the sales voucher. Same way you'll be creating. Okay, go to accounting vouchers, select the sales voucher. See, this is the panel, key panel. So you have to open the sales voucher. Which key is it? F8. Okay, all the keys are written here. So press F8, sales voucher. Then enter the voucher date. Party's name will be Angel Public School. In the sales ledger, you have to select the sales account. This ledger is already created. Select it. Okay, don't create all over again. Duplicate ledgers are not to be created. Select name of the item as CCTV. Select the unit. Enter quantity as 30 units and rate as 12,000 per unit. So 30 into 12,000 will be the calculated amount. That calculation you don't have to do. Then outside the total, select the SGST, select the CGST. It will be automatically calculated percentage wise on your grand total. And then save and accept it. So it will look like this. This is a sales voucher to the Party Angel School. Sales account, CCTV, 30 units at 12,000 per unit, gives you 3,60,000. And SGST, CGST is calculated on this, and the grand total is here. Okay, so this is how you create the sales and the purchase voucher with inventory and GST. Fine, do the steps properly as shown. Now to see the reports, when you print it, it looks like this. It won't be printed as in yellow color and all these green things and all that. Those won't be printed. When you print it, okay, Alt P is the key. When you print, you will get a printout this way. The name of the party will come here, okay. The other party's name will come here, date, invoice number, the inventory stock item, quantity, rate, the SGST, CGST, the grand total, okay, all the other details, CST, SGST, percentage, everything, all the details will come here. So how you will see this report? To display the reports from Gateway of Tally, you have to go to Display Daybook and then you have to check the sales voucher which is there. So many vouchers will be there, but whichever are the sales voucher, you have to check when you want to see the sales voucher. If you want to check purchase voucher, you will go to day book and purchase vouchers. And finally, there is the GST report. So display, you have to go to statutory reports. In that, there is GST option. Then there are other options, GST R1, GST R2, annual computation. These three options are there. So see the report one by one. This is the GST annual computation report, which is visible here on the screen. Okay, the GST and number which we had input, everything is printed properly. It will show you the taxable amount on CGST and SGST and the total amount. So all the details will be printed like this. Follow? So this was one problem solution. In the next session, we'll be seeing another problem of GST with different type. Thank you.